like you're going to punch me or something.
On the news station, Fox 4.
Newsy's doozy with hockey. The Fort Worth Brahmas still playing hockey. They beat Oklahoma today, and Lord Stanley's Cup pays a visit. Hugh Carbonneau on hand, Andy Moog as well. Players and owners that usually compete for hockey's Holy Grail aren't even talking about ways to end their lockout, but the Cup lives on. It's Newsy's doozy tonight.
O'clock one morning, and my husband thought I was sick, and he said, what's wrong? And I said, I've just decided how we're going to paint the house. He's red, white, and blue. He said, go back to sleep.
But Mina got straight to work, painting the wood red and white, the shutters blue, and stenciling on white stars. She even has red, white, and blue lawn furniture, red, white, and blue flowers, and of course a mailbox painted. Well, you get the picture.
Mina even has a 2,700-pound Statue of Liberty in her front yard, painted the exact color as the original in New York City.
But the patriotic fascination doesn't stop outside. Wait till you get a good look inside. Says friends and strangers alike get a kick out of her passion for patriotism.
I know they all think I'm nuts. They'll call me Miss America, Miss Patriotic, you know, hey, Miss Red, White, and Blue, you know, just.
But Mina says she's not patriotic only in times of crisis. She says it's always been in her blood.
It's the greatest country we've got. I mean, with the worst of circumstances, we live in the greatest country there is. And I think we need to show it.
My home, sweet home.
Teresa Adams is moving on, but she doesn't think that she'll ever recover from the loss of her precious daughter.
Well, Deborah, our lives have been changed forever, and our hearts are broken forever.
Liza Adams says she relives that awful day every day.
And every day is difficult. Some days are okay, some days are awful, and some days are really awful.
Liza still talks to her daughter Mary Lou every day. 26-year-old Mary Lou Haig was a research analyst on the 89th floor of Tower 2. Liza says even with finding some remains, she still doesn't feel any closure.
But they found a small piece of remains, Mary Lou's left arm, from below her elbow and above her wrist, a couple inches, two pieces of bone with a little bit of tissue attached, and that did nothing for closure. I really don't think there is closure for this kind of thing.
But Liza loves to talk about her daughter, the world traveler.
And she went to London, she went to Paris, she went to Iceland. Those pictures are downstairs. And one weekend, she decided to go to Nice for the weekend. So she went to Nice for the weekend. But she loved to take pictures, so she has kind of pictures reminiscent of all her little trips.
When Liza and her family moved Mary Lou's furniture and belongings from her New York apartment, Liza decorated Mary Lou's old bedroom the exact same way, pictures and all.
Does it give you comfort to have it like this?
Oh, it's wonderful. I think some people think I've made it a shrine or something, and I don't think I have. I just enjoy coming up here and looking at the pictures she had because she traveled so much.
And Liza still gets cards and gifts from strangers, like this woman from Columbus, Ohio.
We too have three daughters and can't imagine how such grief could be handled. This is another mom remembering Mary Lou.
Liza says her strength comes from God.
And I know that he had nothing to do with this. I know this was evil, terrible, terrible evil. But I know that someday I will see Mary Lou again.
But Liza literally hears Mary Lou's voice every day. She retrieved her daughter's answering machine from her New York apartment.
That's all I have left.
Liza says she doesn't think September 11th should become a national holiday, but she says it should be an anniversary so America never forgets.
I hope that we all as Americans remember what we share with one another and the responsibility that we have to one another. And of course, I want everyone to honor the heroism and the sacrifices that they all made September 11th.
Liza and her family attended ceremonies in New York City today where they placed a rose in Mary Lou's memory in the footprints of the Twin Towers, which will eventually become part of the permanent memorial.
We have digital computers, digital cameras, and now digital mammography machines. St. Francis Hospital in Charleston is the only hospital in the state to have the world's first all-digital mammography system. Doctors believe it's already saving lives.
So we're just going to lower the compression.
When Sharon Anderson went in for her yearly mammography test, she got good news and bad news. The bad news was she had cancer. The good news, doctors caught it extremely early.
Normally it's 1 centimeters before they find a breast tumor on you. Mine was 0.2. That's how sensitive this machine is. So we know I'm a walking miracle.
Sharon credits this new digital mammography machine at St. Francis Hospital. Major benefits include better visibility and detail of breast tissue and the ability to generate images within seconds and magnify and manipulate those images, eliminating the need for many patient callbacks as with traditional film-based systems.
The images come up on that computer and we're able to manipulate the images to lighten them, darken them, just look at different areas of the breast, different structures, the glandular tissue and the fatty tissue to evaluate the images without radiating the patient again and compressing the patient again.
Exams with the traditional film-based machines can take 30 minutes or more, but another major benefit of the digital machine is that exams can take less than half the time, only 10 to 15 minutes.
See these teeny tiny clusters? That's Sharon's cancer.
She would not have felt this probably for months or maybe years. depending on how fast growing this type of cancer was.
My husband's been telling everybody about it, you know. I bet he's already seen 50 people over here.
A clearer picture is clearing the way for more lives saved.
Now, Sharon had a needle localization to remove the cancer, and her breast was saved. For the rest of this month, St. Francis Hospital is offering digital mammograms for $150, and most insurance covers the cost.